Hello friends, I welcome you all to Doubt Forum. This question is, an infinitely long straight conductor carries a current of 5 ampere as shown. An electron is moving with a speed of 10 to the power 5 meter per second parallel to the conductor. The perpendicular distance between the electron and the conductor is 20 centimeter at an instant. And we are asked to calculate the magnitude of the force experienced by the electron at that instant. And here four options are given. This is the given figure. Here there is an electron. This electron is moving with a speed of 10 to the power 5 meter per second parallel to the conductor. This PQ is a straight infinitely long conductor which carries a current equals 5 ampere. The perpendicular distance between the electron and the conductor is given as 20 centimeter. And we are asked to find the force experienced by this electron. As we all know that electron is a charged particle. So suppose this is a charged particle, the magnitude of charge is Q. So any charged particle could experience force due to the presence of electric field as well as the magnetic field. And we all know that the force experienced by a charged particle due to an electric field is given by, let me denote it with Fe, that is the force due to the presence of electric field. This would be equal to the charge, that is Q, multiplied by the magnitude of the electric field. Here the direction of force would be in the direction of electric field. Similar to this, if we talk about the magnetic field, the total force experienced by this charged particle Q due to the presence of magnetic field is given by, let me denote that Fm, that is the force due to the presence of magnitude. This is equal to the magnitude of charge into V, that is the speed at which the electron or the charged particle is moving, cross the value of magnetic field. The direction of this force due to the presence of magnetic field is determined by the right hand rule, and that I will be explaining in a little while. Here in this question, there is a conductor which is carrying a 5 ampere current. So first of all, we have to understand that what are the field produced by a current carrying conductor. Does it produce the electric field and magnetic field both, or does it produce only magnetic field and no electric field is produced by a current carrying conductor? A current carrying conductor produces only magnetic field and no electric field is produced by a current carrying conductor. So the question arises, why a current carrying conductor does not produce electric field? And the second question is, why does a current carrying conductor have a magnetic field? Why a current carrying conductor does not produce electric field? I will be explaining it here. But the reason why does a current carrying conductor produce a magnetic field, I will not explaining this concept here, because if I explain it here, it would become a very lengthy topic because it is related with the theory of relativity given by Einstein. So first of all, let's see why a current carrying conductor does not produce electric field. From the basics of electric field, we all know that suppose there is a charge. So this charge would have certain influence around it, and that influence we named it as the electric field of that charge. So for an electric field, there has to be a charge. But what happens in case of a current carrying conductor? Suppose this is a conductor. A conductor is electrically neutral. Initially, when there is no current flowing, that conductor is electrically neutral. It means the total positive charge is equal to the total negative charge. Now, what happens when we connect this conductor across a battery? A current starts flowing through this. And we all know that current is nothing but the movement of charge. So what happens here that initially when the conductor was not connected across this voltage source, no current was flowing and the net charge on that conductor was zero. But due to the connection of this conductor across a battery, certain amount of charge is injected on this conductor. So suppose 10 number of charge is injected on this conductor at any instant. So what will happen? The same amount of charge, that is the 10Q, would be removed from the another portion of that conductor. So the same amount of charge, that is 10Q, would be removed from the conductor at the same time. So at any instant, we would see that the net charge on that conductor would still be zero, because the amount of charge injected on this conductor is equal to the amount of charge removed from this conductor. So when a conductor carries a current, still the net charge on that conductor would be zero. And when the net charge is zero, there would be no electric field. In an electrically neutral material, the electric field produced by the positive particle would cancel the electric field produced by the negative charges. So the net electric field on that electrically neutral material would be zero. And same is the case when a conductor carries a current. The total amount of electric field produced by the positive charge would cancel the electric field produced by the negative charge. And in that case, the net electric field produced by a current carrying conductor would be zero. That's why a current carrying conductor does not produce electric field. So in this formula, we will not be using this force, because this force is applicable when there is an influence of electric field. Now, all we need to do is to find this force. And this force is nothing but the force on a charged particle Q due to the presence of magnetic field B. And from this formula, we can easily see that a charged particle would experience a force in a magnetic field only when there is a velocity, or there is a relative motion between the charged particle and the magnetic field. Because if we just put the value of V as zero, the net force due to the magnetic field would become zero. So this velocity plays a very important role if we want to calculate the force due to the presence of magnetic field. So that is what's happening in this question. There is a velocity, and that velocity is equal to 10 to the power 5 meter per second. The next thing which we have to find out, just to get the total force experienced by this charged particle, is the amount of magnetic field presence. So for that, we need to find the magnetic field produced by a current carrying conductor. Whenever there's a current flow in a wire, it creates a circular magnetic field around the wire. So if we just take this example, let's say this is a conductor and there is a current I flowing in this direction. So there would be a circular path around this. That circular path would be representing the magnetic field produced by this current carrying conductor. And the direction is given by like this. The direction of this circular path of magnetic field can easily be determined by using the right hand thumb rule, in which we have to point our thumb in the direction of flow of current, and the finger curled would determine the direction of the magnetic field produced. So if we just take our right hand and if we put our thumb in the direction of the current flow, then our finger curl of our finger would be telling us the direction of magnetic field produced by this current carrying conductor. And the second thing is, what would be its magnitude? The magnitude of the magnetic field that is given by letter B, due to an infinitely long straight current carrying conductor, is given by as mu naught into the magnitude of current divided by 2 pi into r. Here B is representing the magnitude of the magnetic field. R is the distance from the wire where the magnetic field is calculated. So if you want to calculate the magnetic field here, so this would be the perpendicular distance from the current carrying wire and the point where we are interested to find the magnetic field. And I is the magnitude of current flowing through that conductor. Mu naught is representing the permeability, and its value for free space and vacuum is given by 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7. The unit of magnetic field is Tesla. So if we just want to find out the unit for this permeability, its unit would be Tesla into meter upon ampere. So this would be its unit. And in this question, a 5 ampere current is flowing. So if we want to find out the magnetic field due to that current carrying conductor, we have to put the value of I as 5 ampere, and the perpendicular distance between the conductor and the electron at a given instant is 20 centimeter. So that 20 centimeter would be nothing but 0.2 meter. So if we just put the value of I and R in this formula, we can easily find out the magnitude of the magnetic field produced by an infinitely long conductor carrying a current equals 5 ampere at a distance 20 centimeter. So we just put the values The mu naught is 4 pi 10 to the power minus 7 into the value of current is 5 ampere divided by 2 pi into r is 20 centimeter, that is equal to 0.2 meter. So we will easily find out its value. This would cancel twice. This would 10 times. So this would be 50 into 10 to the power minus 7 Tesla. So this is the magnitude of magnetic field. Now we have to find out the force experienced by this 50 into 10 to the power minus 7 Tesla magnetic field on this electron, which is moving with a velocity equals 0. With a velocity equals 10 to the power 5 meter per second parallel to the conductor. The force experienced by a charged particle in a magnetic field, and the magnitude of magnetic field we have just calculated, and its value had come out to 50 into 10 to the power minus 7 Tesla, can easily be found out using this formula. And in this formula, the value of B is known to us. The velocity is also given, and its velocity was 10 to the power 5 meter per second. The next thing was the charge, and we all know that the charge in a electron is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. So simply by putting these all values in this formula, we can easily find out the total force experienced by this charged particle, and that force is due to the magnetic field alone. This would be equal to charge is 1.6 10 to the power minus 19 into velocity is 10 to the power 5, which is given. The magnitude of magnetic field is 50 into 10 to the power minus 7. So here this would come out to, so 1.6 into 50 would be 80 into this 19 plus 5 minus 7. This would be 10 to the power minus 21, or it would become 8 into 10 to the power minus 20, and the value of force is in Newton. This would be our answer. Let me quickly revise this problem once again. Whenever a charged particle is placed in an electric field or in a magnetic field, this charged particle would experience a force. The force exerted on this charged particle due to electric field is given by this formula, and due to magnetic field it is given by this formula. As we can see that here, a infinitely long conductor through which a 5 ampere current is flowing, and we all know that a current carrying conductor produces magnetic field alone. The electric field produced by a current carrying conductor is equal to zero. So in this charged particle, the force due to electric field would be zero. We have to use this formula alone. So in this formula, the magnitude of charge is known to us. The velocity is also known to us. The first thing which we have to find out is the magnetic field. The formula for magnetic field produced by an infinitely long conductor carrying a current equals I at a distance, or at a perpendicular distance r, is calculated by using this formula. Derivation part is not covered in this video. For that, I will make a separate video. So if in this formula we just put the value of I as 5 ampere, the value of r as 0.2 meter, and these two are the constants. So by putting all the values, we can easily find out the value of magnetic field, and its value come out to be 50 into 10 to the power minus 7 Tesla. Now all we need to do is to put the values in this force formula Q, V and B, and that is being done here. The charge on electron is 1.6 10 to the power minus 19. The velocity is given as 10 to the power 5 meter per second. The magnitude of magnetic field we have just calculated, and its value is 50 into 10 to the power minus 7. And if we just multiply all these numbers, we will get 8 into 10 to the power minus 20 Newton. So our option number 4 is the correct one. So thank you for watching. If you still have any doubt, please let me know in the comment section. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel, Doubt Forum. See you in the next video. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.